Welcome to the early years, where we aim to talk about the stuff you wish you'd known before trying to conceive.
We were all told, especially us women, about not getting pregnant at school. It was kind of drummed into us that you mustn't get pregnant and what you needed to do in order to not get pregnant, rather than actually having it explained in terms of our fertile health. We knew about, we had the biology bit, so we knew the kind of bits that we had, but I don't think it was really as clearly explained as we really need it to be.
No, you're absolutely right. And I think whilst we had the biology, I don't think we really had the understanding of the menstrual cycle and exactly what happens and when and why and what that means for your fertility and how actually when you do try to conceive, it's just such a finite time that you've got to be able to conceive naturally.
From destigmatising periods.
A recent survey from Plan International says that 1 in 4 British girls say that they felt really unprepared for the start of their period or actually didn't even know what was happening when they had their period. And that's really where we came to create the journal from. We really feel very strongly about taking away that apprehension, the uncertainty, the taboo element of even just kind of talking about periods and replace it with knowledge, a feeling of empowerment and ultimately celebration.
To make sure you've really thought of everything.
Today, HIV is very simply managed. So someone who has got HIV, once they have been diagnosed, they're on the right treatment and within months, the virus becomes undetectable. And then two things happen. Even if they have sex without condom with a partner will not get the infection. The risk to partner if somebody is on proper treatment is practically zero. Similarly, if such a woman becomes pregnant, the risk of passing the infection to the baby, either whilst the baby is in the uterus, in the womb, or at the time of delivery, is virtually zero.
And if you do need fertility treatment, you know the right places to find out the best information.
Some clinics will give out a leaflet that's maybe sort of 30 pages long about IVF and it tells you everything in one go. And it's probably just information overload and not very well written.
Be sure to subscribe to the Fertility Podcast in your favourite podcast app, because once we've looked at the early years in terms of your fertility, we'll be talking about what you also need to know in the later years.